This video introduces the use of conditions in survey solutions. Conditions are used in the Survey Solutions Designer for two purposes: to enable questions and to validate them. We will talk first about enabling conditions. When a question is disabled, the interviewer will not be able to enter data into it. When a question is enabled, the interviewer can and should enter data for that question. If no enabling condition is specified, the question is enabled by default. Enabling conditions are used to control what is often called the skip pattern, or the data path, or routing. For example, in this questionnaire segment, question named pregnancy is skipped if the response to question Marstat is never married or the respondent is male. An enabling condition in question named pregnancy will only allow entry for this question if the response to Marstat is 1, 2, 3, or 4, and the response to question named sex is 2. An enabling condition is a statement that evaluates to being either true or false. For example, this statement will always be true since 2 is always greater than 1. So this is not a very useful condition. Conditions are useful when they include the names of variables in the survey. In this example, we would only want to ask the question about pregnancy if the respondent is female, that is, if the variable named sex has a value of 2. Therefore, this would evaluate to true only if the response to the sex question was female, and the question about pregnancy would only be asked among female respondents. Note that we use double equal signs to denote a test for equality in conditions, and that responses are indicated by the codes assigned to variables, not their labels. So far, this is a very simple enabling condition. Enabling conditions may be as complex as you need them to be. In this example, we only want to ask the pregnancy status of women who have ever been married. We can combine conditions using and, or, and parentheses. And conditions are indicated with double ampersands, and or conditions are indicated with the double pipe. So this would limit access to the pregnancy question to only female respondents who were ever married. Note that the parentheses should be used whenever a combination of and or is used. Otherwise, Survey Solutions will decide the order in which the operators are evaluated, and those results may not be what you expect. Logical operators are used in conditions to compare values. So far, we have only used the equality logical operator. In this table, A and B can be numeric values, the names of numeric variables, or the names of categorical single select variables. For example, to enable a question for only women who are between the ages of 15 and 49 inclusive, these logical operators can also be used with text values and variables. That will be covered in another video. There are other tools that must be used for categorical multi-select variables. Since a categorical multi-select variable might have any number of selected values, we cannot use the double equals to test if those values are equal, even if only one was selected. The simplest of these tools is the contains function, where value is a number or the name of a numeric variable. In general, functions and conditions have this format, where question is the name of the question or variable name from the designer, function is the name of the function, and the parameter list includes values or variable names as required by the particular function. For example, you may want to know the distance to the nearest doctor that has been used by the respondent. You could first ask a categorical multi-response question to find out where the respondent obtained health services. Then you can ask about the distance to the doctor by limiting the responses to those who said they used a private doctor. This means that the question named Doc Dist will only be enabled if private doctor was one of or the only option selected from MedFacil. There are many functions available for use in Survey Solutions conditions, including others for testing selections from a multi-select question. These will be discussed in a later video on functions. Note that you can use enabling conditions on any part of the questionnaire, including questions, sections, subsections, and rosters. By using enabling conditions for sections, subsections, and rosters, you can control entry for many questions at once without defining enabling conditions for each one. Validation conditions work the same way as enabling conditions in that they both produce a true or false result. The enabling condition will determine if a question is to be asked by the interviewer. A validation condition has a different purpose. It determines if the response that was entered was valid. If the validation condition is false, an error message is displayed in red on the interviewer's tablet. If the value is corrected, the message will be removed from the tablet screen. For example, if you ask the question, "How many people are in this household?" you may want to be sure that the number entered is greater than 0 and less than some number that is very unlikely, perhaps 50. The designer allows you to refer to the current variable name in conditions using the word self. This will make it easier to reuse this logic in another variable by copying and pasting the text. Validation conditions use the same language or syntax as enabling conditions. They use the same logical operators and functions and can be used as complex as needed. They can both use the word self. Validation conditions are optional for all variables. If no validation condition is included, any response is considered valid. But when you do enter a validation condition, you must also enter an error message. This message will appear above the response on the interviewer's tablet. In this example, we could include this message. If you enter 51, an error message will appear. The error will disappear once you change the value to 5. After you have entered either an enabling or validation condition, or both, you must save the variable before working on another part of the questionnaire. After saving the changes, you are advised to compile the questionnaire to make sure all of the conditions are correct. If there is an error in any variable, an error message will be displayed. It is good practice to compile and correct all errors on each variable before moving on to another variable or section. This video discussed a number of functions that are available for use in conditions, such as contains. There are actually many functions that can be used with conditions in survey solutions, and these will be discussed in more detail in a future video. This is only a partial list of functions that are available. While describing conditions in this video, we briefly mentioned that they can be used with rosters. There are several tools provided by Survey Solutions that can be used with conditions related to rosters and the variables they contain. These will be described in a future video. The questionnaire used in this tutorial can be found under the Public Questionnaires tab in Questionnaire Designer. It is named Simple Conditions Tutorial.